Hi, my name is Mateus. Do you like sea turtles?
Hi, my name is Syra. Can you imagine a world without Nemo?
My name is Sophia, and our project is about diminishing coral reefs.
Hi, my name is Macy, and we're the mitochondrias.
The coral reefs are a foundation species that serve as a source of food, habitat, and reproductive grounds for more than 7,000 species. As global water temperatures rise, coral reefs are bleaching at an alarming rate. 40 years ago, this wasn't an issue, but today, 50 to 80% of our reefs have been lost. In 2016 alone, 29% of the coral on the Great Barrier Reef died. Marine scientist Renee Setter states that by the year 2100, there will be no suitable coral habitats remaining. Therefore, it is evident that changes need to be made.
The main issue affecting coral reefs is coral bleaching. Coral has a symbiotic relationship with an algae called zooxanthal. These algae are the coral's food source and are what give the coral their color. This relationship becomes strained as ocean temperatures rise and the algae dies. Without the algae, the coral loses its food and turns white, leaving it more susceptible to diseases which kill it.
We decided to draw a graph depicting the overall trend of the rising temperatures of the ocean in relation to the coral bleaching point, which was represented by the red line, and that was the temperature at which the coral was bleaching and dying. And as we can see, as it gets closer to 2013, it surpassed that point.
Solutions to restoring the coral reefs is growing and planting healthy corals. The National Oceanic and Atmospheric Administration, also known as the NOAA, facilitates and funds efforts to grow corals under safe conditions, often in laboratories. They work with partnered organizations to collect both broken fragments and detached colonies of corals, and then grow them in dense coral nurseries. After growing, the corals are then replanted or reattached to the reefs using zip ties, cement, or nails. This is a great solution because it works on regrowing current corals. However, this solution does not address the fact that the reason the corals are suffering is because of the warmer temperatures in the water. So, when these new corals are replanted, they're just going to suffer the same way the old ones did.
So, one solution that research is going into now is using nanocerial particles to help heal stressed and sick oxidative algae. And this algae will become healthy. And that algae can be put back into coral where it belongs. However, this is fairly recent and new research, and there still needs to be some more studies done to actually apply this into the field.
Another solution which is being implemented to restore the coral reefs is the Clean Water Act. The Environmental Protection Agency is using the Clean Water Act program to reduce land-based sources of pollution which lead to coral reef degradation. Their goal is to address the local stressors, like pollution, to help improve the coral reef's health by enhancing their natural resilience. One strength of the solution includes the fact that the Clean Water Act specifically addresses pollution affecting coral reefs. By working with specific organizations and focusing on specific pollution sources, the Clean Water Act is helping to prevent further damage to the world's coral reefs. One weakness the solution has is the fact that it is attempting to prevent degradation instead of fixing the current dead/bleached coral reefs. This solution is looking to ensure more damage doesn't occur in the future instead of addressing the damage that has already been done in the past. To directly combat this issue, our plan is to create a machine which will cool the water directly around the coral reefs. This machine will filter in the warm water, use fans to decrease the temperature, and then push out cold water. It will be made out of metal for durability and will be coated in a thin layer of acrylic to prevent leaking. The fan components will be made out of a sustainable plastic material to prevent rusting. This entire machine will be solar powered, with the solar panels being connected to a buoy above the machine. The buoy will not only house the solar panels, but will also act as an indicator indicating where these machines are located. Over 65% of the coral reefs in the Indian Ocean and the Middle East are under stress by local threats like overfishing and coral bleaching, and almost 50% of coral reefs in the Pacific are threatened. This means that important species like dolphins, eels, seahorses, sponges, and other animals are threatened and in danger. We need to act now.